That's what happened.
Anybody else wants to come help the same, we'll be glad to have them.
Glad here?
Yes. One seat.
I was wandering far from Jesus in the path of sin and shame.
Life could be found. I heard a friend.
name sang it, you know? But it still went real good. And that ain't no way that I could have jumped to that tenor if the bass track on that down too fast. Do what? Appreciate it. Thankful heart, thankful. They done some good singing at first.
Yeah.
Love you. You come try.
Hey, I'll let them hang with me.
You ain't retired, have you, Bonnie?
No, I ain't retired, but.
She done some good singing.
Slowing down.
They say this will heal happen.
That's a real good one.
Yeah.
Listen.
We will rise up from the grave to meet the Lamb.
Praise the Lord.
Father, mother, sister, brother.
Thank you, Lord.
I will see. They'll be coming for. And the
Yeah.
You'll come for the
I see you.
Don't you want to go home?
Don't you want to go home?
Get on your big mother and stay in town. For your
father, he left you.
Don't you wanna go? Where are you gonna be?
Be what you gonna be, Dickinson.
When it's getting.
Till that strong head flow.
When you.
Lord, I know that change.
Good to see you, Bobby.
Will you be rock? Will you be.
Alright.
No worries, Pastor.
Living in all the times. Lord, shall come and take these chills from the blues.
Where are you gonna.
Be what you gonna be, Dickinson.
When you.
Till that strong head flow. Lord, shall come and take these chills from the blues.
I'd say it's a little bit short, but then.
I can't say anything.
Will you.
Living in all the times. Lord, shall come and take these chills from the blues.
When.
Lord, shall come and take these chills from the blues. Take us.
You gotta get a time.
That's right.
That's what you could.
I love to see a family group like that that gets along with each other, smiles on their face, singing for the Lord and spirit. Don't get no better than that. Well, soon we're going to prepare. If you got anybody that you want, please feel free.
I'll keep my three. Remember our old home? Well, remember Kathy and I. She not going to.
This broke a noon or two.
Anybody else?
Charlie, I'd like to turn the cake. Me and you. Thank you for the prayers and everything that came out good. Helped me with my meditation. It means a lot while I was in the hospital.
God be blessed. Glad to hear that. Anybody else?
Remember to check. Kathy. Shane ain't doing good. Kathy Shore.
Got a lot of sickness in the land.
Yeah.
Seems like you get one thing straightened up or something else pops up. Ain't it good to be here, Christian men and women, to be able to worship God's spirit of truth? All the good blessings that He poured down in the life through the years. Okay. I think of what Brother Jay Turber said years ago, that this young brother in the church. He's talking about butcher paper. He said, you just start trying to remember everything, the good things that the Lord done for you, start filling that paper out and rolling. Said, when you get her done, you flip it over and start filling the other side out. Said, you're still not covered off. I mean, just think of the things that He does for us every day. Thank God for that. That's why we come together to worship Him in spirit and in truth, give Him praise and glory and honor. And, you know, He loves us, and we bring our petitions, and night or day. And we ask Him of things, and He'll answer them.
Yes, He will.
And sometimes He says no for a little while. But it seems like things, you know, has to work that way. But then we'll see the answer out, you know, out in the future a lot of times. Some of the answers we haven't seen yet. We're still waiting on them.
Right.
Maybe over in Heaven's country that we see the end of those things that we've asked for, we thought we didn't get, but we got exactly what God wanted us to have and we need. And so we need to trust Him, don't we?
Amen.
All things work together for good to those that love the Lord and are called according to His purpose. And He knows the best thing for all of us. And yes, we'll trust Him that way.
Yes,
you know what Job said one time? He said, though thou slay me, yet will I trust in thee. Think about that. Though thou slay me. Because he trusted, sis, that the Lord knows best for him. And if slaying him was the best, and the Lord said that was the best,
that's the best. That's it.
Think about it. It's hard for us, the carnal minded, to think about those things, but He knows the future, He knows the outcome of all things. So, but we pray that God's hand will be upon our sick folks and touch them and heal them, if it's the Lord's will, and they can come back to church and be able to be with us, you know, the family of God. Think about it. Anybody else?
Brother Charlie. Go ahead.
Remember my friend Jennifer that was diagnosed with cancer.
She's had to be admitted to the hospital for other complications, but she's in a mess. The whole family is, just remember.
Do the best she has.
You remember my wife, and she did no good, I hate to say that, it's true. And my daughter, she went back last week, and they gave her a good report, so thank God for that. But yeah, the baby one.
Good.
Seemed like it's just one hand around it, and to me, you that one, you're a second.
We're at that.
But that's life for us, brother.
We're getting at that age, you know.
Hey, don't look back, there's nothing back there.
No.
Always play all right up. Our picture, right out there, we're doing in the near future, brother, for us all.
Absolutely, yeah.
But Jim, I remember the little kids that they got hurt at the ballpark, and they were in the papers, or they said they were still in the hospitals.
Those things like that, you just never know when the bottom's gonna fall out or something, you know, and I mean literally. And that's the way it is with all of our lives, and Christians and lost people. We never know that last day that we're gonna be here, that last moment. And that's why the Lord, he's foretold us to be ready and to stay ready. And we're glad for our lost friends and loved ones that's here tonight, and you know that you can get ready tonight.
That's right.
And the Lord said the very hour that you turn your whole heart over to me, he said, I'll be found with you, you know.
That's right.
He said, come, listen how simple he made it. Man, he loves us. He knows how carnal-minded and ignorant that we once was, and we still sometimes are when we're studying the scriptures. Christians have been in here for a long time. We're still carnal-minded sometimes. Paul talked about that. But he loves us so much that he's so long-suffering and patient with us, not willing that any should perish, but all come under repentance. He said, come to me in faith believing, in other words, believe this, faith believing, repenting, with a broken and contrite spirit. That's taken right down where we live, right down inside. Knowing that God is real, and knowing that he loves us so much that he unbosomed his son to suffer our death and our pain on the cross, that we can have the choice of eternal life, joy unspeakable. Think about it. Manifold blessings in this life and everlasting life to come. Look what the Lord's done for us. And just to come to him with a broken, contrite spirit, he said, in no wise will I turn you away. Make you sons and daughters of the Most High God. And the Most High God will be your Father. And he wants that. That's why that he sent Jesus.
That's right.
He wants that.
If Jesus would have got up off the cross and ascended back, and he could.
He could.
But you and I or the world would not be saved.
We'd still be lost.
He'll be lost, hell bound.
That's exactly right.
But that was love that made him slave right there. I can go through that for not only us, but for the will of the Father.
Absolutely. Amen. Anybody else before we go to prayer?
Charlie, I'd like for y'all to remember the Wayne Community Tent Revival that we're going to be having this week. Yeah. Pray that there'll be a lot of lost souls decide to give their life to the Lord.
Absolutely, yeah.
Brother Charlie, I'd like the church to remember me. I'm a little nervous, but I've got to go have some nerve test done on my hand and my arms. I've got neuropathy and arthritis in them, and they said maybe carpal tunnel, which I'm not going to try to have any kind of surgery because neuropathy is caused from my sugar, and it'll never get better, ever. So there's no need to be cut on and try to have something done that will help the other family. So remember me in your prayers that I can continue to deal with this. I have a lot of trouble sleeping and resting from it. And another thing, I want to thank the Lord. I'm going to spend the day in church this morning with my granddaughter, my oldest granddaughter, and good service there. A man held his hand for prayer. My granddaughter stood with her head on down. And another young man, let's remember him in our prayers.
God
will
bless you, yes.
And I'm just so thankful he saved my soul, that I could be alive to my children and grandchildren.
God will bless, yes.
And I haven't been in church with her since she was a little girl. But I do believe that when his word went out and she was little, she heard it. And it don't come back void. Someone here is.
Praise the Lord, yes.
But I'm blessed to be in there with them today. A good little place
good.
To be, good people.
also the revival's going on again tonight, and I don't know if it will continue, probably not, but I know it's going on up there at Turkey Creek, so remember them. Also, there was a couple of others that had been walking the aisle, and were praying for them. Yeah. Don't know their names, but God knows them, and we pray for them, that they'll give it up, you know, give their life to the Lord. And we're thankful for the ones that they did baptize today. God added to the church today, they should be saved. He's still in the saving business. And he don't get tired of saving. And it brings joy to us, Brother Chris, down in our heart. The Spirit of God that dwells in us when somebody gives their life to the Lord, if we don't even know, you know, carnally know them, you know, we still rejoice, brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus. Think about that. So that's what we want to pray for our lost people, whether they're here up the road, down the road. Like Sis mentioned, that revival, we want people to be saved. Anybody else when we go to prayer?
I always remember me and my home, my family. I remember Tracy Skilton. I haven't heard anything about her in a few days, but last I heard, they found her in the swamp, and she's just had one heck of a time. One Christmas, Butler's mom. But it just seemed like there was one thing after another with her. You know, remember her and her family. And my brother and his family, he's doing well health-wise, but they got some stuff going on, and I wish y'all pray that the Lord would protect him and his family. Certain situation they're in, and he has two grandbabies on the way. One was just born a few months ago, and one's having a little trouble. So just doing with them too. But most importantly, one of them's got their house in order as far as being married and stuff, but they don't belong to church. And then just remember that part, most importantly. The other ones don't really have their house in order or in church or anything. So I wish they'd get in church and raise their babies in the church.
Anybody else?
Remember our family, Brother Charlie, and our lost people. Remember my mom. And remember Michaela. She's starting a new job this week. She needs her prayers.
Yes. Good.
Brother Charlie, there was two young girls baptized today over here at Glory Hole, about the Romney Ridge. And Macri Sires baptized them. I don't know who they were, but I seen the video of them little gals come up out of there shouting. So let's just pray they can hang strong for the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, thank the Lord, yes. The doctor, and I think that he's wrong, but I'm going to say it anyway, I said that mommy has Alzheimer's. And I asked her some questions. I was worried, you know, I heard about it. Up her revival, Rick was telling me. He said she's in bad shape, you know, but he presented it. Worries me. So I go visit her the next day, and I asked her the same questions. I mean, not exactly the same questions. She can't hear good. And when she's put under pressure, she can't answer good. And I knew that, and I asked her, and everything I asked her was just right down the line. And so, but I want y'all to pray for her anyway. She's 85 years old, and of course I love her. We want to keep her as long as we can, since she's a good little woman. So remember her. Also, Sister Rachel, she's still fighting that old bone cancer. So, and she's wanting to get back to the radio program so fast. Fred tells me that every time. So remember them when you pray. Anybody else?
Remember Sister Diane Moore's family. She buried one of her great grandbabies this morning. Mm. She was only 4 years old. She had a bad heart, and her grandmother, the one that is next to the wife, the daughter, was supposed to be giving her blood pressure medicine for her heart, and for some reason she forgot it, and they couldn't save her.
I'll do bless. Anybody else? All that would like to have a part in this prayer, that lift your hand. God be bless each and every home represented. Anybody else? If there's nobody else, Brother Paul, would you lead us in this prayer? Everybody pray.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for bringing us this way this evening, Lord.
Good morning.
Thank you for being here with us.
Looking on the face.
Having your many blessings that you bestowed upon us all.
Lord, we just pray.
Lord, we have the service this evening, Lord. For blessings on the table, Lord.
While there's little service, Lord.
Know you more than those that don't. We bless you with your gift this evening. And we just pray that everything we do here this evening will be a blessing unto you.
Joys in this world.
Thank you so much, Lord, for coming this way this evening.
She might be more of a turn.
Thank you, Lord, a special blessing on every prayer request we've heard here.
Oh, God, we bring these.
Thank you, Lord, for seeing you, Lord.
If you have mercy on us, Lord.
You're all in all, people.
And the Lord, to turn on this, Lord, you can go over. And the great progress of your soul, God, we ask that.
We pray you forgive us, Lord, for being so.
Lord, as long as we're left one, we ask that you would come here.
As long as you are seeing.
That you are a great company. God, most of all, those that I know you would bless to do. And Lord, in this special year, this evening, our families, we all have our loss.
Here's the time that we're going to do.
Neighbors, relatives, Lord, we just ask that such blessings come off of us. That they'll turn their life over to you, Lord, for us everlasting. Lord, we just ask that you would just come bless us. Be ours, and also Jesus, Lord, and so. And that we, Lord, we just ask, Lord, that you would just pour out a blessing. That you come to us, Lord, this evening, Lord, that we can rejoice in us, Lord. And we will embrace you, Lord, in our honor that it just would be, Lord. God, we love you, we pray for your holy name, we love everything for that, our Lord, and all the rest of the story. Honor for us, God, we pray that you bless that little revival that's going on still in Fertilizer, that them souls will be saved, Lord and God. And that revival that's going to be starting up down there at the tent, Lord, down the plain, we ask the blessings upon the brothers, Lord, them young brothers, that they'll bring forth the word. Lord, in a way that people can be saved, your Father, we know it's you that added to the church today, we should be saved. Lord, we know that we're just a little old vessel here upon this earth. And as Isaiah said, just make me a hollow shaft and hide me in that quiver. Pull me out from time to time and put me in that old bowl. Point it to where you want it to go, and it shall not return unto you void, but shall accomplish whereunto that you give it, Lord. God, we just ask that you bless this little service, and it'll truly be a worship service unto you, to give you praise and glory and honor. Lord, we want to thank you for all the blessings that you poured down on us, the things that we've seen, that you've answered our prayers. God, I thank you so much. I look back through the little crowd this evening, and boy, I see a lot of prayers that have been answered, Lord, that you've saved our soul. Lord, that's the best prayer that ever could be answered, that you can save our soul. Lord, we have our friends here this evening that we love dearly, and if they know how much that we love, well, if they really just know how much that you love them, Lord, I believe they can come to give their life to you, Lord, and serve the Lord's call today. Lord, we just ask that you would just reveal yourself unto them once again this evening. Lord, whether it be I or they, so that Jesus is preaching, so they believe, would you reveal yourself real strong to them this evening? Show them that great love that you have towards mankind, that you're not willing that any should perish, but all would come unto repentance. But they could live, Lord, and have manifold blessings in this life, everlasting life to come when life is over. Lord, we love you. We praise your holy name. Love and be thankful that are worthy of all praise and glory and honor, King of kings, Lord of lords, my Savior, my High Priest, that I can come to day and night as you listen to my prayers and my petitions. And I want to give you thanks for that once again. You're my best friend, Lord. And I want you to be the best friend that you are, Lord, to all your people, and I want your lost people to know and understand that you're their best friend, Lord. That you want them dearly, Lord, that you come to give your life for them, Lord, that they can have this life and this opportunity to eternal life, Lord. All these prayers and blessings we ask in the sweet name of Jesus, who we love and adore.
And amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Y'all, we've had a good time this weekend. All you that's come up there, we appreciate that so much. Manifesting your love to our neighbor churches. There is but one church, really.
That's right.
Church of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're thankful to be a part of it. Just a little pinch here in yonder. Man, you know what? God bless old John to write it in scriptures there in Revelation, said there was a number that no man could number. So it's not just a little bunch. It seems like it in this old wicked world, just a little bunch. And I'm telling you, down through the generations of time, when he's gathered us all together, as they've sung so beautifully in those songs, that's true, that come right from the Word of God.
Amen.
One day after a while, that the Lord's going to come back. Listen, he was talking about that the Lord would come back. And listen, we that which are alive and remain when he comes, and it could be Brother Chris right now. We which are alive, that's talking about us, and remain, shall not prevent them which are asleep. That's our loved ones that's asleep there.
Amen.
And they talking about lost people. They're dead. He talking about saved people. They're asleep. And you can sure see the difference in there. To which we are alive and remain shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ. Look at there. The twain again, ain't it? The dead in Christ shall rise first, and we which are alive and remain shall be changed in a moment of a twinkle of an eye, and be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and forever be with the Lord.
Amen.
That is the truth.
That's the truth.
And listen, we as Christians this evening, we say, come Lord Jesus, come quickly. Because we get this good spirit that's a stirring down in our life, and it is so, so good.
Yeah.
And boy, I'm like Brother Tim Napper. I thought about what he said years ago. He said, boys, he said, I'd like to be able to just open it up and take a dipper. Take a little bit out and give you some of it, and you can come. Yeah. But it don't work that way. You got to come the same way I come. That's what he said a long time ago, and it's still true this evening, Brother Paul, that they've got to believe it with all their heart, soul, strength, and mind, like I was talking about before, and in the prayer there, that they can have this good salvation.
Yeah.
But the Lord, I'm telling you, he's teaching better than any warm blanket in the frostiest winter time to cover us up with that great love and warmth. There ain't nothing better than that in all the world. I've been outside in the old world, and I've tasted of all kinds of evil things and play purties that the devil had for me, and none of it can compare or touch what God has given me just in those few short years. And I'm telling you that he's got it to give to every individual that will receive it. Like I said there a while ago, the very moment that you give your whole heart unto the Lord, he said, I'll be found with you. How glorious is that? Think about how good that is. I was thinking about what I was speaking about up there at Turkey Creek, coming back to my mind. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Who was saying that? Jesus. He's the one that told the old Isaiah, said, write this down, Isaiah.
Yeah.
He talking about that old prophet a long time, about 720 years before, that he come and spoke it himself in his own flesh. He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel unto the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance unto the captives. Boy, I was in captivity. We all was of the old devil at one time. He had us bound up. He had no compassion, no mercy. He told us a pack of lies to keep us outside the kingdom and church of the living God for years and years and years. But the Word of God come and preach to me the same thing that Jesus said. I preach deliverance unto the captives, to give sight to the blind and give me some sight. I wasn't blind naturally, but I sure was blind spiritually. And he gave me sight that I could see out in the future here and know that God is. And he's a rewarder to them that diligently seek him. He showed us Christian men and women that we wanted to get a hold of that. What else? To set at liberty them that are bruised, and to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. And when he got through saying a great big service there, he closed the book up and gave to the minister, and he went and sat down. And I'm telling you that it was quiet in that little church building that morning.
Yeah, yeah.
Because nobody had ever heard somebody speak with authority and power like this man called Jesus. That Brother Paul, he's still the same one. And he's inside of us. And if we'll get creature out of the way, he can bring forth a message that will save souls. No man cometh unto my Father except through and by me. And no man cometh unto me, Jesus said, except my Father draw him or her. Think about that. You know what he said when he was sitting there in front of that little synagogue? He said, this day is this scripture fulfilled in your heart. And they know, Brother James, that it was talking about the Messiah to come. They believed the word of the prophecy of Isaiah. And when he quoted it there, and he said, this day is this scripture fulfilled in your ear. They know that he was claiming to be the Messiah.
Amen.
Amen.
And he claimed truth. Because he is the Messiah.
Right.
He was the promised one. Right. They expected Brother John Jesus coming as a great natural king. Well, they're still doing it over yonder. They're still looking for a great natural king. That's the foolishness of the carnal mind. Jesus didn't come down here in the natural to impress natural-minded people. He come down here lowly in the volume of the book. It's written of me to do thy will, O God. And when he come, he started doing the will of God, humble, a little carpenter's son. And he began to be a priest, the word of God. He said, I speak not my words, but every word my Father giveth me, I speak them. I come not to do my works, but every work my Father gives me, I work it, and he done it well and good.
Amen.
He said to them old boys at that time, he said, ye shall surely say this proverb unto me, physician, heal thyself. Do here in your country as you've done in Capernaum. He hadn't even went over in Capernaum yet. He was telling them what they was going to shortly say. Just a little bit out in the future, he knows all things. And I'm telling you, they latched a hold of him, thinking that he was a blasphemer, claiming to be the Son of the living God, and he is. And they grabbed a hold of him and was going to throw him over a hill headlong and kill him and away with Jesus. What are they hollering this day and time? Away with Jesus. I don't want to retain the thoughts of God in my heart or mind. As it says in the first chapter of Romans, that's the way the world is. They don't want to hear about Jesus. Away with Jesus. It's the same as it was at that time. That's the working of the Antichrist, the devil. He's always been here. He's not yet to come. He's here. And he's going to and fro in this earth and up and down in it, seeking whom he may devour. He's got the world. And Brother John, he wants us.
Yes, he does.
God said, Peter, you mean a chosen vessel of God, an apostle?
Oh, yeah.
Jesus, God in the flesh, said, Peter, the devil desires to sift thee like wheat. Don't you think about that? That's a little tiny pieces, ain't it? The devil wants to tear us apart, don't he?
Yeah.
Make us little tiny pieces.
Yeah.
Nothing in the eyes of people that we can reach out and try to help somebody. Destroy us. He come to destroy, to steal and to kill. And he's still doing it, and he's doing a bad job of it. I don't like to say the devil's doing a good job at nothing. Everything that he does is bad. He's doing a bad job of it. Whoa, glory. And he's got the world and wants to keep him right there. He had me in the world when I reached the age of accountability. I know to do good and done it not. It was sin unto me, and he had me. And he had me convinced that I was doing my thing. And I was doing my thing, but guess what my thing is? The devil's thing.
Amen.
He had me right there.
Yeah.
But praise be to God, the word come. That same word that was preached in that little synagogue that morning, they wanted to kill him headlong over the hill there, and he just passed through the midst of it.
Yeah, right.
Where'd he go? Where'd he go?
That's right. He did.
The world was saying, where'd he go? Where'd he go? Right here. That's here's where he's always wanted to dwell. And he will, if we'll open up our hearts door, let him come in. He'll clean us up, make us a brand new fit creature, a temple. This is the temple of God that he made.
That's
That's right.
Jesus directed us to understand when he said, you tear this temple down in 3 days and we'll raise it. They thought they were talking about that old natural temple over there. They're still thinking about that old natural. All we're going to build a pretty one. And the Lord's going to come down from heaven and sit on it. He's going to rule this nation with a rod of iron. He's already. He's done sitting on the throne at the right hand of the Father, ruling and reigning. He's got all power in heaven and earth. That's what the scripture says. I ain't making this up. He's got the keys of death and hell. Hey, that's power. In other words, he can bind you up right there or he can loose you. It's your choice. It was our choice, wasn't it, Brother John? We chose the good path, didn't we? We wanted to be loose from that bondage of sin and death and hell forevermore. And Jesus has made the way for us that we can do that. Think about that. What about that Capernaum? Dude here and I. What was his country? Nazareth. Just in a little bit, you can read over Brother Paul where he went to traveling out into Capernaum and different places doing the miracles of God. There's one little fellow there that heard about Jesus, a complete full-blooded Gentile of the Roman sect. A centurion, over 100. That's what I was speaking about, but I never did get to finish that. Praise the Lord, I've been there all night. It's good, though.
Yeah, great.
What is it? What are we talking about? I was hoping them brethren would open up with that faith that I ended there on, but they went a different direction. And it was good. It fit right in.
Right, yeah.
That's where I was going to. And I wanted to go on a little real bad, but boy, I just shut her down. Thank the Lord. I had a fellow come bragging on me about that. Had a good time. I'll tell you, had a good time. Well, I want you to think about this man, full-blooded Gentile that hadn't been raised up with the tutelage of that old covenant at that time, but he loved that nation, and he built them a synagogue. Sounds to me like that he wanted what them Jews had in that old covenant. Sounds to me like that he wanted to know God for himself.
Right. Yeah.
And he sure did, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
He seen the great work. He said, why? Because of faith. That's how we please God. That's how we get God. That's how we please God. That's how we stay in this kingdom, is that faith. That's what opened it up that we could come in. God's already done all the work through his son Jesus, but he said this faith is in you. How do you know it's already in you? This word in which we preach, it is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart, the word of faith. In your mouth? Lost man, lost woman, in your heart. That's what God said.
Yeah.
God give every man a portion of faith.
A nation.
Sure. Do you know that it spoke about Jesus that he was so full of faith that you couldn't measure it? What are we talking about? We're talking about God in the flesh, that whatever that he spoke would come about right then and there if he wanted to. Whatever he done would be right then and there finished and fulfilled. Whatever that he wanted is going to be just that way. We're not like that. We have just a little portion of faith that we can add to it and grow a Christian man and woman. But if you're lost, that faith has not been unlocked down inside of you. How do you get that faith unlocked? By hearing the word of God and by believing it and by moving out on it. Hey, the devils, this is where I was going there up there. I'm jumping the gun a little bit. But the devils, they fear and they tremble. Why? Because they believe God. And listen, it takes more to go to heaven's country than just belief. If that's all it took, they could make it, couldn't they?
Yeah.
But they're in chains of darkness.
Yeah, they ain't.
Didn't say they had faith, Brother John. Said they believed. That's the beginning of faith.
Right.
That's what I see.
John said, show me thy faith without your works. And I'll show you my faith by my works.
Amen.
Here's that word.
The body without the spirit is dead. If we don't have that spirit that God placed down inside of us, we would die. That's what happens to our people when they die, that the Lord calls that spirit out. Either that spirit is going to be in bondage forevermore, or that spirit's going to be in that glorious place.
place with Jesus. I'm going to prepare a place for you where that I am. You can be also in my Father's house or many mansions. One day after a while, he's going to come back from that resting place with that spirit and soul of man that's made ready and put it inside the glorified body. Then we'll go to that high heaven. That's what I like to say, where God dwells. Amen. All of us are going, Roger Ramsey says it quite often, and it's the truth. We'll all go to heaven at the same time. But now as we leave out of here, our loved ones, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. What part's present with the Lord? That part he come in and cleaned up. He that is born of God sinneth not. That's that inward man. Ain't got no sin in it. Ain't got no sin. Why? Because God cleaned it up. And he's dwelling there. He can't come down in there. But I'll tell you what. You better watch this right here. It'll mess everything up. He that is born of God sinneth not. But he that is begotten of God keepeth himself, that that wicked one touch him not. So that's a job for us Christian men and women.
It is.
I ain't trying to paint a pretty picture here. I'm trying to tell people what the truth.
Amen.
Yeah. Amen. Now when he went over there and that centurion was there and he heard about Jesus and he respected Jesus, him being a Jew and the centurion being a Gentile, he understood that at that time. That's the way it was a difference. And he went and sent for his Jewish friends that he'd helped and know well to speak on his behalf. And they went to where Jesus was at. And they bragged on that man and said, he's a good man. He deserves for you to do this for him. Ain't it good to have somebody in your corner?
You ain't kidding.
We've got someone greater than that in our corner, and his name is Jesus. He sits at the right hand of the Father, making intercession on our behalf. When we come to him with a broken and contrite spirit, he'll not turn us away. He'll turn to the Father and say, Father, this man and woman has given their life unto us. And the Father will say, glory. Your work was not in vain, was it? No. Jesus' work not in vain.
No. That's right.
Amen. None of it. It will accomplish whereunto that he sends him. He's still doing it. Shall not return unto him void. No. Wherever he sends it. Wherever he pleases to send it, he'll accomplish. What's he going to accomplish? We hope that it'll save souls. I'm telling you that he'll accomplish something else. That in judgment, our people that would not accept that by faith, it'll stand against them.
You got to make a decision.
It'll stand against them strongly.
I
believe with all my heart that the Lord will remind them, say, hey, do you remember when I spoke to your heart and that you almost was persuaded? Almost persuaded. And you turned me away?
Look what you could have.
He that's ashamed here in this world to proclaim the name of Jesus. He said, I will be ashamed to proclaim you in the presence of my Father.
That's where he's here.
He means what he said, Brother Chris.
And that's all. That'll be all.
When that little fellow there that sent for Jesus, and Jesus didn't question and ask a lot of things. He just turned and started following them Jew boys back to that man's house. You mean a Gentile man's house? Mm-hmm. He's going to go right in a Gentile man's house and break that old covenant. These two commandments overpowers all that's ever been said. Love the Lord thy God with all your heart, soul, strength, and mind. And to love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Yeah.
Now that's the truth. And he was willing to go into a Gentile man's house, and them Jews are watching him. Did you see what he was going to do? But you know what that old Gentile man did? He thought that out. He said, now I know their law. He better know it because he changed.
Yeah.
He changed direction. He sent one of his servants out and met Jesus on the way.
Yeah.
Said, Jesus, I ain't worthy that you would come under my roof.
I got sick, kid.
Neither did I think that myself was worthy to come to you. That's where we need to be, Brother Paul. know that we're not worthy to come to full majesty called Jesus, the Son of the living God. And when we come with that humbleness of heart, He will not turn us away. He'll recognize us. Listen, when we self-exalt ourselves, He said He shall abase them. But when we humble ourselves, He said, I shall lift them up. Man, there's a big difference the way the world looks at things and the way God looks at things. Ain't
yeah.
When that man sent that messenger to Jesus, said, I ain't worthy you come under the roof of my house. Neither did I think myself worthy to come unto thee. But just say in a word, and my servant that's sick unto death shall be healed. That's faith.
Yep.
No doubt.
Great faith.
Well, if you'll do this, maybe he'll be healed.
He will be.
Lost man, lost woman, do you want to be saved? You shall be saved.
You shall be.
No maybe, ifs, ands, or buts. God done said it.
Yeah.
If you come God's way, there ain't no maybes about it, Brother Paul.
No ifs, ands, or buts.
And it ain't hard. It ain't impossible. Mm-hmm. If it was, you're looking at a little fellow that's ignorant than an old son. And the Lord loved me enough that He revealed unto me Himself and let me know that He saved my soul. And He will the next one the same way. Listen, that old boy, when he said, just say a word and my servant shall be healed, Jesus began to say, and He turned to them Jews and the ones that was following, He said, no, not in all of Israel have I seen such great faith as this. Think about that. This was a Gentile man, had been brought up under the tutelage of the old covenant, but yet he believed enough and had faith in this man called Jesus, and that his servant would be healed, shall be healed. And you know what? He was.
Right.
The same self-hour. They went and checked. God had it rubbed down in the mud. Let the snow for sure. That fellow got well. Remember when we was asking her a while ago for our loved ones? If you believe, you shall receive.
Amen.
It's our fault. May it be unto you according to your faith. He said that many times to them old boys and girls back in the old scriptures.
Yeah.
In the New Testament too. You know, they said that to them according to your faith. So then it's our fault if things don't come. Now, sometimes, like I said a while ago, sometimes things got to roll out the way the Lord wanted to roll out. If it's God's will.
Yeah,
it's
God's way.
He went to another place. It wasn't the church house, but actually it was a church house. Because it turned into, there's a fella had a house, and he decided to have a little church service. And Jesus was right in the midst, and there was a great crowd. You remember back, older folks? I'm one of them older folks. Back when we used to go to people's house when they were kind of sick, they wanted a church service. We still do that once in a while. But I'm telling you, that was a great multitude that would come sometimes.
Yeah.
Fill the house up. Mm-hmm. Have a good service, priesthood. That's what they're doing there in the scriptures. That's what God wants. If they can't come to church,
go to them.
Lord was traveling. He's in this little house. And He's preaching the Word of God. And while he's preaching the Word of God, and there's so many in that little house that you can't get in the windows or doors. And this old boy heard about Jesus down the road. And he's close by. Yeah, he's close by this evening. He is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. This word of faith in which we preach. If you want him, open up your heart's door and you'll have him. Just like I did and all these preaching men and women done several years ago. So Jesus was preaching to them. Here come them fellows, they couldn't get in. Well, let's just go on home. Things just ain't rolling out the way I pictured it down the road there. That's what a lot of people does, Brother Bruce.
Yeah.
God put these in here in the scriptures for an example, Brother Paul.
That's right.
I see them old boys, they try to figure out. You know what my boys, they tell me, said, when I'm trying to figure something out to work on to fix it my way, since spending $100 for something other that ain't going to last no ways, I'll make something.
Yeah, what's a day and a half?
There you go. My boys tell me, Dad, you can figure it out. Them boys figured it out. They didn't go back home, did they?
No.
They had to work real hard in getting what they wanted. We did too, didn't we?
Yeah.
Had to get this creature out of the way. And I'm telling you that it hurts to die, don't it?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, but it was good.
It's nature. It's good.
Just as quick as it died, life come down on the inside. Boy, I've got it. The Lord has forgiven me of my sins. I feel lots better. That's the way I felt. Sin gone. Glory! Ain't that good? That's the best. The old boy said, I know what I'll do. I'm going to pack my buddies here. They all have faith. I'm going to pack him up on the roof while Jesus is preaching. We won't bother him. He won't care. They tore that roof all to pieces. Can you see Jesus going right ahead preaching to that crowd there? And the dust rolling down. You know it was, Brother Chris. Them old house, tearing that roof up. Dust rolled down. And then he's preaching up a storm. And them other fellas, you know, get sidetracked in there, no doubt, look and said, oh my goodness. That's a crazy bunch of birds. Turn this man's roof up. Just a few minutes, they had a big enough hole there. I don't know exactly how it came about. I know they got that old boy in. They set him down, sick of palsy, right in his bed, right in front of Jesus. And Jesus said, I see your faith. You all's faith. All of them. He knows when a man working with that faith. He knows when a woman is working with that faith. And when you work with that faith and add to it, it'll grow and get stronger. And he likes that. Even out of us that's been in for 38, 40 years. He still wants us to grow in his grace and all of his truth.
That's what he said.
I like his. Son, he called that old man there in that sick of the palsy in the bed. Son, thy sins are forgiven thee. Listen, let me tell you, Brother Paul, he could have went home a happy man. Yeah. Crippled up. He could have. His sins were forgiven. Why? How come?
Faith.
Call it faith.
Faith, brother.
You went to some trouble to get in front of Jesus. Are you going to some trouble this evening to get where Jesus is at? He's here.
He is.
I've done said he's nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. And you know that little still small voice is speaking to you, just like it did us. Said, son, now you know that you're lost. You know I'll give you all kinds of opportunities. He had, Brother John, he's given us all kinds of opportunities. He did me. You know that I might not ever give you another opportunity. You know that it's not in the scriptures that I promise that I'll give you opportunity. No, he said one time. Oh my goodness, you mean to tell me that I was that blessed that he touched me several times?
You was blessed.
I was blessed.
He was blessed. I was.
I had Christian people praying for me. Didn't that make a difference?
Yeah, it was.
Yes. Absolutely, it made a big difference.
Big difference.
Son, my sins are forgiven thee. Boy, I'm going to tell you, there's a bunch of hypocrites in that church house too, isn't there? They started murmuring from their heart. Mr. Leach, now who in the world does he think he is? Only God can forgive sin. He's blaspheming. Jesus knew what they were thinking. He knew what they were thinking and saying and whispering to each other. He knows everything about everything. Yeah. Yeah. Don't let those crazy things get in your way. Do what the Lord said for you to do, and you'll be a happy little pilgrim on your journey. Them boys didn't care what them fellas was going to say or think. They know that Jesus had the power to give their little friend that was in palsy in that bed there something that was glorious, and he's done give it to him. Son, thy sins are forgiven thee. Jesus perceived what they was whispering and murmuring about. Him preaching, boy, that power. Which is easier, he said to that crowd. To say unto him, son, thy sins are forgiven thee. Or to say unto him, take up thy bed and walk. Boys, there's some proof in that, ain't there?
Yeah.
If you're going to say that, Paul, it better happen or they'll call you a false prophet, won't they?
Yeah.
Well, he had the power to say it and it came back. That you may believe that the Son of God hath power upon this earth. I say unto this man, sick the palsy. Take up thy bed and walk. And he took his bed up and leaped with joy walking, going to his house rejoicing, for his sins were forgiven him, and he was made whole.
Happy man.
One of these days, Brother Bruce, we're going to be completely made whole. Amen. Right now, we've got our sins forgiven. And the Lord helps us along the way, keeps us a little strength to keep on keeping on until it's time to go. Man, I need that strength physically, mentally, and spiritually. Don't you all? I know you do. You're just like me. When that man jumped up and he proved that the Lord was the Lord and he wasn't a false prophet, I thought that he had power from God to do this miracle. A fear fell upon them. We've seen strange things today. Man, I tell you, all those miracles that he'd come up with, fellas that was crazy out of their minds with devils, Brother Paul, and he'd speak the word, go! And them devils had to go. Did I have a devil with me a few years ago? Man, Paul, he started shaking that head right off. Yeah, I remember you, Charlie. We did, didn't we?
Yes, we did.
You are serving one of two masters. Either that you'll serve the great God, I am the creator of heaven and earth, and all things therein through his son Jesus. Or you're serving the God of this world that's got the world's mind deceived, and else that the glorious light of the gospel should shine down inside of them and reveal to them the God of heaven through his son Jesus. World's blind. Remember what he said there in that little synagogue? Give sight to the blind. He gave natural sight to the blind too. You know those miracles that he done to prove that he was truly the Son of God, and I believe it. How about you? Well, I know you do.
Yes.
Christian man, women, think about that. You know what? You can read a little farther over there that all those wonderful miracles that he was doing in Capernaum, them old Nazarites, them Nazarenes over there in his hometown, said, Jesus, would you come over here and heal my daughter? Jesus, would you come over here and do this and do that? They changed their mind, didn't they?
They believed.
Fulfilling that prophecy that he had said right there in that little synagogue that morning.
Yeah.
You shall surely say this proverb unto me, physician, heal thyself. Do in thy country as thou hast done in Capernaum. Was Capernaum perfect? Man, some of that was rougher than an old dog, a junkyard dog. You know what he said to him one time in Capernaum? He said, the things that have been preached here in you, if they've been preached in Sodom, they'd have repented a long time ago. What's he saying to them? That they ain't repented. Those glorious miracles and things that he'd done and preaching, and they wouldn't repent. That it was going to be easier in the judgment for Sodom than it was going to be on them. Because if Jesus would have preached like he preached there in Capernaum back in the days of Sodom and Gomorrah, they'd have changed their mind. He knew that. But yet, Jesus didn't preach to them. That's a mystery, ain't it?
Yeah.
Not at that time. But you know what? He spoke to them people at that time. You know why I'm thinking about this Sodom and Gomorrah? Oh my goodness, because it's getting like that again, brother. These same false gods that God had passed judgment on the way back there in the time of Egypt, and before that and after that, passed judgment against them. Evil, evil gods destroyed them. And their idols and things, changing everything. This nation and this world is still, this day and time, are raising up these old false gods again. They are. What he said in the scripture, even as it was in the days of Sodom and Gomorrah, so shall it be in the days of the coming of the Son of Man.
Yeah.
He sent a feller over there. If
I remember this, Craig. I ain't even thought about this in a long time. That there was a fighting nation that come down and took a lot of the people out of Sodom and Gomorrah and the riches and their wives and took them over to their foreign land by force. And God sent a man called Abraham, a great man, to fight for them. And Abraham went with his army, and he must have had a big army. And he went and fought for them, Sodom and Gomorrah. God sent them. Look how God loved people. God knows what's going on in that place. He gave them one more chance. One more chance. God is, I mean, he don't pass judgment, Brother Tim. He just compels. He's long-suffering to us, for not willing that any should perish, but all come unto repentance.
Amen.
He's given people chance and chance again to repent, and they keep passing it up. But you'll get tired of it after a while.
Yes, he will, yeah.
And I'm telling you that Abraham went and fought with his men and took everything back from them that they took out of Sodom and Gomorrah, and them wives and them children, everything, and was bringing it all back, a great caravan, back to Sodom and Gomorrah, showing the power of God through a man of God that had faith. And on the way back, he run across the guy that was called Melchizedek.
Yeah. Yeah.
And he recognized that he was the servant of the Most High God. He was a priest. And it wasn't from the Levitical priesthood, because they hadn't even come along yet. Abraham recognized that man because he had God in him. And he gave not what he had took back that was belonged to Sodom. The more I heard preacher preaching, I thought, man, you're off course there. He brought all that back to Sodom and Gomorrah, showing the goodness of God. He took a tenth of his own money. You can't please God by giving somebody else stuff. Boy, that's killer. I heard a preacher preach that one time. I thought, man, you're off killing bad on that one. He gave a tenth of what he had to that man. And you know what it says in the book of Hebrews? That Jesus come not as the high priest through the Levitical priesthood, but he come after the order of Melchizedek.
Right.
And in the likeness of Melchizedek. And that man had no beginning of time and no ending of days. Had no descent. You mean God can do that? You ain't kidding. He put Adam here, didn't he?
Yeah.
Come from God, didn't he?
Yeah.
He put Jesus here, didn't he? Mary didn't know him, man. Boy, she know God, didn't she? You think God can do anything? He absolutely can. Look how that all these things ties together to prove truly, Brother James, that God is God.
Right.
And that he loves us. Amen. And that he's went way out of his way to reach our people.
Yeah.
And he's give our people again this evening one more chance, an opportunity,
yeah,
to turn their life over,
yeah,
to the Lord.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you, my people, that I have thought about this. And I'm in at the house when I'm praying. I'll be praying for, I can see your all faces in my mind. I'm not kidding you. I'm sure the other Christian men were in the same way.
Oh, yeah.
See your faces in my mind. And I'm praying to the Lord, Lord, reach down to them. Whatever that it takes, reach down to save their soul. I don't want them to die and go to hell. And you know what the Lord sometimes shows me? It scares me. This is the truth of the matter. I can see their pale face in the casket with no hope. And my heart goes. You ever do that?
That's scary now.
That's the most frightening thing that I could even mention. Die without hope. Die without Jesus.
Yes.
Most frightening thing. Not have an advocate with the Father, which is Christ Jesus, that is just to forgive us of all of our sins. The best lawyer that you could ever get a hold of. It don't cost you a dime. He'll stand for you, I'm telling you, and the world's on fire. And all that it takes is to love God. Because he loved us first.
That's right.
And love.
That's a part of that faith, Brother Chris.
Exactly.
That when we truly believe that God is, and he's a rewarder to us that's diligently seeking, that we manifest ourselves. Jesus said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. What was one of the commandments? Confess me with your mouth. What was another command? Be buried with me into my death and raised up with me in newness of life. If you love me, you'll keep my commandments. You mean to tell me it's that simple? It's that simple, see, exactly. To believe that, and a believer is what? James, go right back to the book of James, is a doer. The body without the spirit is dead. That's what it said. And so is faith without works, that it's dead also. That faith that's inside of you that God will leave right there and remain till the last breath goes out of you, God will look at it as it's dead. And God put it there until that you turn the key and open that faith up. That means to do it on. You mean to tell me it's that simple?
Amen. Yeah. We make it complicated sometimes.
Do what God said to do, and he'll save my soul. Yes, you ain't kidding.
No lies.
Right here from the heart. Don't let the devil put these here, I call them crazy thoughts. And like I said here a while back, I'm a scientist at heart. I like to try to figure things out. I mean, that's just my nature. You can't figure this out.
Something figured out.
I've wasted months of trying to see what I need to do with what I'm trying to figure out. Just believe it and do it. I figured it out. It's like what Brother Chris said, it done been figured out. God fixed it all.
Amen.
Every bit made it simple. Though a man be a fool, a wayfarer man, he should not err therein. There ain't a fool in this house. Though a man be a fool, a wayfarer man, he should not err therein. You know what it said about a fool in the scripture? A fool has said in his heart there is no God. I don't believe there's a fool in this house.
They ain't.
I believe they know that there is a God. I believe that's why they're here. That was the same way that I was. I know there was a God. That's why I was there. But he wants us to do something. He wants us to believe it so much that we'll not be ashamed, not be bashful, come up and say, I believe the Lord Jesus Christ is the Son of God. I believe he saved my soul. I believe if I do what he said to do, confess him and be buried with him in water baptism, that I'll live forever.
Amen.
And we will.
Amen.
And that begins at the very moment, Brother John, that we turn our whole soul over to the Lord, we begin to live. And we shall never die.
Really?
That's what I say.
But Paul, we shall never die.
Amen.
We're alive on the inside, quickened, brought alive. We shall never die. This who makes us who we are, that last breath that goes out of this creature here, and that soul comes, you see, the body without the spirit is dead. The body's dead, not that soul. Not that spirit. It'll just come right up out of there. Boy, you can't see it. One scripture talked and described about these angels that was dispatched from heaven, got a hold of a little fellow named Lazarus, because he'd been living right. Boys, he'd had a rough time though, wouldn't he?
Yes.
He was there, he was in poverty, brother. I mean, that's what you call poverty. Yes. Didn't have a roof over his house. Dogs had compassion, licking, you know, his sores and things. He needed a doctor. Didn't have no money. Somebody must have had some kind of compassion and said he met a rich man's gate, thinking, well, that rich man had a little compassion on him. It don't say all of that in scripture, but you can picture it in your mind. Why was he there?
Yeah.
Rich man must have just back and forward, you know, because he knew exactly when he saw where he was sitting, he knew who he was, didn't he?
He did.
Must have known him, did he?
He did.
Desired the crumbs that fell off the rich man's table. Never got any. No compassion. Never got compassion. I'm looking at a house, I'm talking about everyone that's in here is full of compassion and mercy. Even our lost people. I've talked to them enough to know that they've got love and compassion and mercy down inside of them.
Right.
Man, they're so close. Sister Robin, they're so close to getting a hold of this good thing. That closer than what they even think.
Yeah.
They're not a fool. We've done already proved that. They're conscious of God. They know that God is. They told me that they believe. That's real close. The devils believe and they tremble. So what is that lacking, that faith? Brother Chris said, faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for. Now, when I had that faith, you did too, brothers. What were we hoping for? If I do what the Lord told me, I'm hoping that He'll save my soul. And He did, didn't He?
Yes.
Yeah.
He will the next one.
He'll do the next one. What is that faith? I know if I serve Him the best that I can, even if I'm falling on my face, messing up, people kicking me around, said that fella will never make it, he'll never last. Said that to Tommy Devon years ago, he's still going. That's where the world is.
That's the devils in the world, Tom.
You're real close. And I know you're real close because I've been there. And I was closer than what I thought that I was and run like a deer because the devil was bidding me to do it. The deceiver.
That's right.
And if our people goes out the door without the Lord in their life, they've been deceived again, Brother Paul. By some way, Brother John, they've been deceived again. And I'm not talking about our people. Man, I've deceived over and over and over, and I thought that I'd done what that I needed to do. I'd hear that voice in there say, well, you're a young man. Now, you know you can't do that. You know you can't be a Christian. You're a young man. You ain't even married. That's a lie. The Lord, when He takes up His abode in us, when we believe and move out, and He said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I'll go with you all the way. I'm going to help you. Greater is He that is in us than He that's in the world. He's strength to us. When we mess up, He might whoop on us a little bit, but He'll say, you're still my son. You're still my daughter. Straighten up now. You can do better than this. He has all of us, hasn't He?
Yes.
We're still here, aren't we, brothers, sisters? The devil is a liar and the father of it, and he wants to take everybody to torment, but Jesus is trying to get the truth across to God's people that He is the way. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the light. Jesus is the life. Jesus is God manifested in the flesh. Jesus is salvation unto the believer. Jesus is eternal life unto the believer. How? You know that scripture, it said, we'll look at that time. Except a man or woman eat of my flesh and drink of my blood, he hath no eternal life abiding in him. And this right here is the word of God. I'm telling you that old John described it a little bit different, but it's the same thing. He said, when you eat this little book up, he said, it'll be sweet as honey in your mouth. He said, when it gets in the belly, it's all flesh. He said, it's going to be bitter.
Yeah.
And that's what the devil uses, Brother Timmy, to keep people out. You can't do that. You'll never make it. Big lie.
It's true.
I'm telling you that honey is so sweet that it tickles me to death when it gets bitter down in me. This flesh, it tickles me. I know that I'm doing right. When it starts cutting this flesh, I know that I'm doing right.
Amen.
It lets me know that I'm doing right when it starts cutting this. Because if it ain't cutting the flesh, you're already gone. But think how good God is to us, long-suffering to us, we're not willing that any should perish, but all come under repentance that you might live.
What's that?
Abraham, going right back to Abraham, was called a friend of God. Why was he called a friend of God?
He was.
Because he walked with God. You mean God walked beside him? No, he didn't say that. I'm telling you that Abraham paid attention to what God was telling him, and he done it. What was he doing? His eating this up. He believed it. He was eating it up. What God told him to do, to a point that God will test a man, when he gets to a certain, or a woman, to a certain point in our life. Let me see how, I want you, now I know what you can stand, but I want to show you what you can stand. I want to show you what you can stand. I know where you stand. And he said in the scripture, he said he would not tempt none of us above what we're able to bear, but with every temptation he'd make a way for our escape.
That's it.
And Abraham was done told by the word of God. He believed this, he eat this up, this is a fact. Ain't no lies about it. When God says something, it's going to be just that way. That's faith. And that's what it said about when Abraham walked with God, it's because of faith. That he believed God. So, God tells Abraham, through and by thy seed Isaac shall all the nations of the world be blessed. One little son there. That one. Isaac. So now, he believed God, didn't he? Let me show you how much he believed God. That time went by, and it didn't leave him. He knew exactly what God said through him, by thy seed, Isaac, shall all the nations of this world be blessed.
Yeah.
I'm going to test you here, Abraham. Did he say, I'm going to test you? No, and he'll not tell you when he's fixing to test you. Either. He's testing me, says, and I fell flat on my face and felt ashamed. And he's tested me a few times. And I come out smelling like a rose. And I said, Lord, you God, I finally passed one. Ain't it good?
Yeah. You learned by that, Paul.
Absolutely, you learned from them, Paul. And then when them good times come along, it's just, good. Well, I learned. Wasn't it me? It was what the Lord was teaching me.
Yeah.
So he tells Abraham, so Abraham, thy son Isaac, you take him up on this hill here and you offer him up to me. You take his life. I've seen these movies talking about Abraham, and he cuts awful shine in the movies ever was. Now, God, you told me, you know, cry around snot.
It didn't happen.
No, sir. That's foolishness. Right. God chooses real good. He chooses men and women that will stand on the truth.
Amen.
And he proves it time and time again. That man did not whimper. He didn't fall.
Didn't question.
He knew exactly, Brother John, that God's truth is truth, that he'll, if I take his life, he'll raise him up right in front of me.
Right. Because he done promised the numerous.
He's done already promised it.
Right, exactly.
And he believed God. That's what it takes.
Yeah.
Now I'm telling you, lost man, lost woman, if you believe that God will raise you up alive forevermore, even though that he may use you up and take your life one day after a while, and we will die. Yeah. More than a man wants to die. God set it in motion, the devil didn't. He may have been an instigator of it and caused it, some of it. But I'm telling you, God set it in motion. He passed the law. He said, pointed unto man wants to die and then the judgment.
Yeah.
That's everybody. Mm-hmm. Abraham believed him. Took that little fella up. Now let me tell you what happened here. Took some of his servants that was helping him pack the wood and stuff and laying on that old mule and stuff. And got to the bottom of that hill and he says to his servants, he said, you fellas remain right here, and me and the lad will go yonder and return.
Right.
That's faith. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go up here. He didn't tell them, but this is what he's going to do. I'm going to go up here because my God told me to do it, and I'm going to take his life, and God's going to raise him up. Now, that's faith.
And we will.
Is God going to do us that way? Not to the point of that. He's making a point here.
Yeah.
Well, God prove to us our faith? You ain't a kid, he will.
Be sealed.
Time and time again.
Oh, yeah.
We must be ready to pass the test. I mean the ultimate test. I mean one day after a while when he comes back. We may fall on our face several times here, but if we'll get back up and he'll dust us off, we get started again like the brother said, and grow, we'll pass that final test. Come shining through. Abraham took that child back there, and that little fella says, well, Daddy, he knows about that. He's done it time and time again, offered up sacrifices to God. Well, Daddy, here's the wood, and here's the fire, and here's the stone set up and everything, you know. Where's the sacrifice? God shall provide himself a lamb. And he sure did. His name is Jesus.
Amen.
And that old man, and man
And I'm telling you, it still hurts my heart thinking about it. Because I always placed my little son, especially when they was little, when I was first studying that, right there, and be with the knife draw back. Man, that hurts. He brought her back, and from his heart, he killed his son. I mean, coming with it, and God sent an angel and said, hey, don't go no farther. Don't do that son no harm. I know for surety that you'll go all the way, Abraham.
He would.
And he's a friend of God. He walked with God. And he had that faith, and he wants us to have that. And we can have that. Because he said we can have it. And he said to grow in his faith. And once we get a hold of this little bit of faith, and it just takes mustard seed of faith to get started. He's making it hard. We can grow God's grace, knowledge of his truth. One day after a while he comes back, he'll say, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Enter into the joys of the Lord forevermore. Because you've been faithful over a few things, we'll make you rule over me. And it ain't talking about ruling over people. I've heard people say that. No. God's rule over people. It's talking about the things that bother us here, it'll never bother us again. We'll have a glorified body and we'll rule. Nothing will bother us, no sin, no sorrow, no death. No confusion is going to enter into that land over yonder.
All right.
Don't you want it?
Go and get it. Go and get it.
Had another opportunity to turn your life over to the Lord.
Amen.
I remember back when I was a young man in the church, and remember Dad and some of them old brothers, Brother John, preaching wonderful. I mean, he's pouring it out. Some of the people that was there, none of that was lost. And I was thinking, well, man, they're going to move. I know they're going to move. I know they got to believe this. That's so plain. They've got to believe this. They've got to know this is real. That's just too good. I heard one brother in the first said, I'm telling you, and he's already Christian. He said, I just about moved again myself. That's how real it gets.
Yeah. I'm still doing that.
Praise the Lord. Think about that.
Amen.
It's real. But you know what? The sad thing was, when I was a young man, and I'm still seeing it time and time again, too many times, Bruce. You have to. Some of our people just bet they got so close that you could almost see him kind of, you know. He'll do that. Move, you know, it's like they're getting ready to move and then let that old deceiver say, you know, something was said to them. They didn't move. And the next time that I saw him, and this is true, looking on the pale face in a coffin.
Yes,
and am I trying to bring fear to you? Yeah, that's what God said. It's at the beginning of wisdom towards God is to fear God.
Yeah.
God means what he says. Pointed unto man wants to die. Old men must die. Oh, not old men, old men must die. And the young will die. In other words, accidents come along, disease comes along. They'll never know when we're going to die. What should we do about it? Live forever. Get that life eternal from that word right there and bring it right down. That faith is right there. They just need to unlock it. Move out on it, and they'll have that eternal life abiding down inside of them. And they go on their way rejoicing, happy little pilgrim on our journey. This is not our permanent dwelling place. This is not our permanent home. Our home is going to be in heaven's country. And they can have it tonight. They can have it. I'd like thankful hearts to come back up and sing some more songs. There's somebody ready for the old church. I want you to move. The church is saying, in the scripture, it's the truth. The church is saying, we that are here of the church, we're saying, every one of us from our hearts have it. Jesus is saying, come.
Amen.
The Father God is saying, come. He made it to where it's possible for him to come. Whosoever will, let him come and drink the water of life freely. While they sing, if there's somebody ready for the church, come up and let it be known. And don't be ashamed. Don't turn this sweet Jesus away.
How about you say something while we're getting ready?
Go ahead, Brother Chris.
It comes to my mind every time I hear you or any of the preachers talk about getting yourself down to you know, nothing, bringing yourself down to nothing. You know, before you're down to nothing, you're thinking you are something. And that's what God don't want. Just imagine God, he done his best work with nothing. With nothing. He started with nothing. That's what he wants us to do. And then he does the work. He does his best work with nothing.
Hey man, that's a good analogy, brother. It is. That's a good example.
Yeah.
Come with nothing, and God will give it all to you.
Oh Lord.
Absolutely. Go ahead and sing.
I was lost in sin and sorrow, on and out in life's dark sea, when I saw Ship of Zion, and it
beautiful song. When nobody moves, that don't mean that you can't move. It's this next song. We think about, we have a way about it to make it simple for people, Brother Bruce. While they sing this next song, if there's one or more here that would be willing to put one foot in front of the other, that's a hard thing to start doing. But it's very important. That's putting this creature under subjection, what you know that the Lord wants you to do. He said, draw nigh to me and I will draw nigh to you. And it shows us that you're serious about your soul, and it's bad to Christian be praying even harder for our people. I know that it affects me, Brother John, when I see people drawing closer to the Lord. So while they sing, and this next song, if there's somebody of the mind, or more than one here of the mind like that, come up and take me by the hand, won't embarrass you, won't kill you, it won't save you, but it goes a long way in the eyes of God about saving your soul. We'll be praying for you. But now I'm telling you that if you feel that still small voice is saying that you want to give your life to the Lord any time during the service, not just because we said it a certain way, any time in the service you turn your life over to the Lord. Even after the service in your home at 3 o'clock in the morning, you give your life over to the Lord, you call me or some of these brothers and we'll try to get together and we'll put you in the walk.
Amen.
That's what God wants and that's what we'll do. Yeah. All the same.
I must be close to the heaven of the shore. And the sounds that I hear must be from heaven's door.
Yeah. song there. Let's move aside and fellowship with one another again this evening. It feels good. Feels good to be in the house of God. Love the Lord this evening. Feel good in His spirit. Have a good week. Good evening. Good day. Thank God for that. We'll be praying for our lost people. I'd like to say this. If there be one or more here this evening, just by the uplift of your hand where you're at right there, but just let us know. We'll be praying for you. God bless that man. God bless those men. God bless. Got a lot to pray for. Thank you, Lord. all about Jesus. Anything else, please? people and the other one.
Are we having a business meeting too Saturday night?
If, well, let's just coordinate how things will go. We probably will kind of get to it quick. I don't think we've got anything we have to cover. But if Roger's here, we'll, and he probably will, but he don't want to rush.
He talked as if he was.
Do what?
He talked as if he was.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good, yeah. I've mentioned before that we might have a Bible study if he didn't, and then go into the hearing for the next day. But I'd really rather just go into the, it just seems like it's just reminding the heart to that, you know. Anyway, we're looking forward to it. It'll be good either way that it turns out.
That'd be next Saturday night?
Yes, this Saturday night coming, right?
Next Saturday, it's their homecoming. That's where Dad and Mom go to the birthday. I'll be out there.
You're coming this Sunday or?
Yeah, this Sunday coming. Second Sunday this month.
No, no, Brother James, you're always here that Sunday. This following, that's when your family cemetery is.
Okay.
You're getting a week ahead of yourself.
Now, you have the radio program too on that.
Sunday.
On that Sunday morning, yes. Anything else?
Brother Charlie, that church we went to this morning, they had church on Wednesdays too. And they said if anybody wanted to come, they'd go on. Well, they'd invite them with open arms.
That's a good place to be. I've been over there a few times. That's a good service. If there's nothing else, Rob Chris, you get dismissed, please.
Heavenly Father, once again, we want to thank you for giving us another day and giving us another opportunity to come and hear the word. Father, we'd ask now that you go with each and every one of us and get us safely home. And Father, we'd ask that the people that's in the house that don't know the Lord and the ones that know the Lord, would let us remember what we've heard this week and let us think on it and be pleasing unto the Lord. Dear Lord, we want to thank you for everything. We ask that you go with us. And we ask that you keep us through the week and bring us back another time. And we ask it in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.